What's going on, folks? It's me, Mikey Pipes. Just got delivery of this Weil-McLain CGa5. 133,000 BTU gas-fired boiler. Atmospheric venting. It's got a damper on there. Uses a chimney, so this is what we consider an 80% efficient system. The yellow sticker is right there. 84% is the AFLU. We have intermittent pilot gas valve, boiler control with spark igniter. Our low water cutoff and temperature probe is right there. Transformer, rollout switch, spill switch, field supplied, line voltage, factory installed 30 PSI pressure valve. And this goes to the circ. I have it on the forklift, my custom built Dioc Industries model MP001 forklift. It's perfect here. We don't go that high. We only go up there if needed, the top shelf to store equipment, but there's no roll cage on it, but it's all good. I have it elevated off the floor a little bit. We're gonna build this thing out a little bit right now. I'm going to not kick the front cover. We're gonna build this out right now. We're gonna put our T there for our triticator gauge. We're gonna come up, and I'm waiting on UPS to deliver today's shipment and order that we placed with supplyhouse.com yesterday. I'm gonna put in a Spirorvent here on the vertical. That's right, a Spirorvent on the vertical. I'm gonna come out of this 1¼-inch tapping with a nipple and then an elbow. I'm gonna put on a 1¼ by 3/4 2-zone pre-built manifold. And you'll see why when you see the boiler we're taking out. Show on the road here. Nailed it. Let's find the one that's open already, like this one. I'm probably gonna get copyright demonetized because of the song playing. Hopefully not. Hopefully not. I like monetized videos. Cha-ching, baby. Cha-ching. Now, I normally... Ooh. Why is that nipple loose? That nipple was on there, wasn't it? Oh, that's no good, man. You guys saw that, right? Did they just put this... Oh, come on. That would have so leaked. Are you serious? You gotta be kidding me. I gotta tell you this, I have never had to take the nipple out that comes factory installed. So that is a big shocker. Big shocker. And the fact that they put no thread sealant on there, pipe joint compound, is embarrassing. And guys, if you install these CGAs or CGIs, you know what I'm talking about. You better check that nipple. I gotta tell you, this dope. It's like dried out. My soil. So right on top of this 1¼ by 1/4-inch T, I'm putting on a 1¼ by 1-inch black reducing bushing. Now my existing system has 1 1-inch supply leaving the boiler room and 4 loops coming back to 2 zones valves on the return. We're going to put our circs on the return right there, and we're gonna maintain 1-inch leaving the boiler with a 1-inch IPS vertical air separator. Let's thread some pipe. Yeah, it would help if I had that lock. Don't forget to ream the pipe. So these cast iron boilers, they come with an ECM circulator. I like to match circulators when I install them on a new boiler. So I put on two Grundfos ECMs here. This is what we got done so far. Not too shabby, huh? Not too shabby. All right, a couple things that we're missing. Inch and a quarter split ring hanger on the end of that inch and a quarter by three quarter two zone header, right to the left of that inch and a quarter cap. I'm gonna do an inch and a quarter split ring hanger there with a piece of 3/8 threaded rod with a little sealing plate right there. I'll drill that into the top corner right there of the boiler jacket. That's gonna hold that up. I'm also gonna take another inch and a quarter split ring hanger, put it here with a 1-inch split ring hanger here with a piece of 3-inch thread rod in the middle, and that's going to hold this from wobbling. You can see it's already starting to shift a little bit. Coming out of that 1/2-inch tapping for air elimination, there's that air eliminator, but it's also where I'm going to bring in water, my boiler supply water. This is the Calefi 1/2-inch pressure using valve. At the field, we'll put on our check valve and valve to connect our domestic water to the boiler. We'll also put on the boiler drain on site. I don't want it to be too wide and become a problem when we bring it into the house and down the stairs. Now that triticator gauge connected to this inch and a quarter by quarter inch T with that bushing there, 1 inch by 1 inch bushing. And then I came up here with a piece of 1 inch, I threaded it, and I have a 1-inch vertical air separator by Spirotherm. Spirorvent, beautiful, magnetic. Don't really need that here, but is what it is. And from here, we'll connect to the 1-inch that is the boiler system supply. So it's looking pretty good here. I have my 6-inch automatic vent damper. Now, I'm also accumulating a pile of paperwork that came with all the components that I'm putting together. Here's that fuel controls vent damper, the GVD, am I right, GVD? GVD6. If you know, you know. If you guys are throwing this out, you're dumb. You have one for standing pilot. You have one for intermittent pilot systems only. Caution, install one of these plugs in the hole in the damper blade per instructions on page 5. Failure to follow these instructions can cause nuisance odor problems and minor property damage due to moisture if ignored. So let's go to page 5. And it tells you right there, installing the knockout plug in the damper blade on gas-fired boilers. So there's the one for hot surface igniter or spark. That's going to go right there into that knockout hole, and we'll bend that into place. Let's just bend this a little bit more there. Beautiful. Excellent. And let's bend these back. Perfect. I got to tell you, it's awesome to build a boiler in the shop where you have an elevated platform. I don't have to bend over. I don't have to sit in a bucket to wire up the relay and wire up the circulators that I just did. So much easier. It's a blessing. I have ran into a problem. So let me show you what I did. So here is our SR502-4 two zone switching relay. Yes, it's an older model. I stock a lot of controls and I buy in bulk. So nonetheless, this is what we're working with. Two zone switching relay. I have my 110 to 24 volt primary secondary transformer. I have my power switch where my line voltage is going to come in. We're going to wire in the switching relay. power to here. This is easy, right? I'm wiring this up and look at this. See this? Beautiful, right? Excellent. We'll wire the two thermostats on site. I'm going to wire in the end switch next shortly. But this plugs into here, right? Easy peasy. Check this out, folks. They never soldered on the pins. Let me bring you into that if I can. Zoom in a little bit. See? Look at that. It was never soldered on. It's crazy. So, nuts. Absolutely nuts. So I called up Taco and the guy's like, oh no, it's not normal. Right? I'm like, yeah, no shit. Come on, look what I went through for this. I don't want to redo this. So I can cut the wire here and wire it there. It'll work, but... And I'm not going to use Argo. I'm just a fan of Taco, and I will never switch from Taco, but... It's a disappointing. Very, very disappointing. Let's go to the shelf and grab another. SR502-4, 1, 2, 3, and SR502, SR503, SR506, SR503. So I stock switching relays because we go through them. This is just disappointing. All right. So I got a brand new SR502-4. Carefully used a pair of needle nose and undid those connectors there. This really sucks. But the joys of doing business, right? Let's just put that off to the side. It's actually not so bad. It's not so bad. It could be much worse. It could be like switching to a different brand, like an Argo. So, it is what it is. I called up Wales Darby. They're the rep for Taco and many other manufacturers. Spoke to John on the phone. He's like, Mike, I got you. Just swap it out. I'll warranty it for you. I'm like, thank you very much. All right, and one more there. And not even 5 minutes later. Let's get this out of there. Okay. Let's take this and drop that right there. Bad. See? Bad. Beautiful. So let's just loosen up the line voltage terminals on zone 1, zone 2, and our input. Come on, baby. Don't let me down. Don't disappoint me. Come on, go in there. There's one. It's going to pop out, isn't it? Yes, I know. Oh, no, it stayed there. Look at that. Okay, I'm trying my best here, folks. Come on, get in there. Oh, man, get in there. Okay, let's get this one. Let's get that one. Not as pretty as it was, I don't think, but we can straighten it out. Good, let's get these two and then that in there. get in there. Perfect. Okay. There's this one. There's that one. And there's that one. Okay. Look at that. So they are all connected now. See? Took a couple minutes, but it's done. All right, I got a lot done today. We're gonna put a 3/4 by 1/2 inch reducing bushing here and hang our extra number 30 right here. We're gonna add that threaded rod on the vertical and the horizontal. I'm getting those parts in tomorrow. The gas is best received on the left side, but I am likely going to, I'm likely going to go straight up. Yeah. We're going to go straight up with the gas. Yep. That's what I'm going to do. I'm going to go straight up with the gas. It's annoying. That is annoying because I have my piping. I got to add a short nipple, a T, and valves because we have 4 pipes. We have a 2. Each zone is split into 2. Let me show you. Here is that Repco boiler. This is our return. Circulators on the return. We have 2 zones, valves there, and they're split into 2. So there's a single pipe leaving. Let me see if I can get you a better picture. This one should be better. There you go. So here is our supply leaving. This is 1-inch copper, and it leaves the boiler room all in 1-inch. So somewhere outside the boiler room, it's split to 2, first floor, second floor. But I'm gonna guess that the first floor, second floor split again, because maybe left and right side of the home, because we have 4 returns, 1 leaving. So that's why we put, that's why we're putting the circulators on the return, and we're not using zonal valves. We're using independent circulators for zoning. And yeah, so gas is on our left-hand side. This is 3/4. There's our power. That's all fine and dandy. We'll figure this out. Maybe we'll mount that box on the ceiling, and it'll be all right. Not too shabby. Not too shabby. So stick around. On Monday of next week is the replacement. And don't forget, folks, if you live in the Long Island, New York area and you're tired of getting bamboozled by your plumber, pick up the phone, give me a call, 516-348-6300, or save time, book your appointment online at pipedoc.net. Catch you in the next one. Be well, God bless, stay safe.